Namaste, Assalamu Alaikum, Sasriyakal. Welcome back to another session with your Vashaf at Vareva.com. Today, you know, I'm going to make another favorite, that is drumstick. And this is even more special because this is from the plant which my mother recently put, and she's so very possessive about these drumsticks. As if she's giving me a share of my property, she gave me 3 drumsticks. So I'm going to use this to make this awesome curry. First, we're going to do the tempering. When you talk about tempering, the best tempering, you need to give mustard, cumin seeds, as well as the methi seeds. When the mustard seeds crackle, you want a very good flavor from the red chilies also. So what we do is, put it in the hot oil and let these red chilies cook in this oil, and you should get that aroma. In this, usually I prefer to use shallots, and if you are using onions in this, add bigger pieces of onion. So once you add these onions, add garlic. See, in my cooking, I may add more ingredients, but the whole intention of adding more ingredients is to make a very rich, not rich in terms of fat, but rich in nutrients. The more ingredients you add, the more tasty and the nutritious your dish is going to become. After garlic, add chopped ginger. Because I'm not adding any other vegetables, so I added extra onions and also drumstick in this. And now add turmeric. Turmeric and hing becomes an integral part of a lot of our cookings. This gives an additional awesome flavor. Add a lot of curry leaves also. We got so many ingredients in this, make this very, very flavorful. In this, we're going to add tamarind juice. You do not want to add too much of tamarind juice. Always the tamarind juice should give the slight sourness, the sourness that enhances the taste. But it should not be so sour the way you eat tamarind rice or anything like that. Pour in some tamarind juice, add water to soak all the ingredients, and add salt to this. Now the drumsticks will get the awesome flavor from cooking with this. And now you're going to add your chili powder. Again, it depends how much chili powder and all the other flavor you want to get. Some coriander powder, some cumin seed powder, not too much. If you want to add garam masala powder, a little bit. This itself is my sambar powder. I've got the awesome flavor, but since we are not going to use the tuvar dal, that what we usually add to our sambar, today we're going to use the chickpea flour, that is the besan. If I add the chickpea flour to this, it thickens, but it won't have the awesome aroma. Slowly, you can dry roast it, or you can add some ghee and dry roast this chickpea flour to a consistency where you will get nice flavor. This is getting cooked. All we're going to do is use chickpea flour to thicken this. So for this, I'm just going to add 1 spoon of ghee and 1.5 spoon of this flour. Slowly, cook it on a very slow flame. You want this chickpea flour to get a nice golden color cooking in this ghee. So reduce the flame and let it cook till this is slightly golden and you get a perfect aroma. And also, we're going to add some jaggery for a little bit of sweetness, not too much. You know, when people have this, they should not think we added any jaggery. It should be to enhance the flavor, not to sweeten the dish. I'm going to cut the tomatoes, a big tomato into 8 pieces. I am going to add it when the whole process is finished. So I think 1 tomato should be good enough. Now I'm getting the nice aroma of Mysore Pak. I want to get it nice sandy color, a little bit dark in color, light color. So we're going to add water. It is going to thicken, and we're going to pour this into this. This is going to be slightly thickened, and now we're going to let this cook for another few minutes. I love the green chili flavor. Add it in the last, before few minutes, add chopped coriander. That will give additional flavor. Your drumstick, a new kind of, it is between a sambar and a rasam, but awesome flavor. When it is slightly more thickened, I'm going to add these tomatoes and switch off the flame. You know, I want to show you the thickness. See, it should be pouring slightly thicker. That means it will coat the rice in such a way that the rice itself becomes very flavorful. The pieces of tomatoes, that should be good enough. You do not want these tomatoes to cook too much. After adding in this, just let it come to a boil, and then we're going to switch off the flame. The tomatoes become nice and juicy. My drumstick, dear friends, awesome, awesome. Shallots and big chunks of onion, you know, is what makes this even more tastier. Drumstick, wow. Wow. These drumsticks are tender, juicy, and just awesome. As I always keep saying, cook awesome food, keep saying whatever, and enjoy life.